Hi, I'm Amy from the Alti store. We're going to take a quick look inside the MidNite Solar Brat. That's their 30 amp PWM charge controller. Now, why did they call it the Brat? Well, because their MPPT charge controller is the kid, so of course you'd call their little one the Brat. So let's take a look what's inside here. We've got a nice NEMA 3R watertight enclosure. Really nice for wet environments like a boat or something. It has the two waterproof gaskets already right on there for the strain relief for the wires. You can have your two wires from your PV going into one, and you've got your two battery wires going out on the other, as well as if you're using it for load control, you would have your load wires in there. And we'll get into that in a little bit. So we'll see what here. We've got the manual, nice manual install guide. And then we've got some swag. Ooh, we've got some toothpicks from MidNite Solar. So that is everything that's in the box. Let's take a closer look inside the Brat itself. Okay, so now I've taken out the four screws so that we can get a little bit closer look inside here. So you see here that we've got a nice waterproof gasket in here. So we've got our NEMA 3R for outdoor conditions. And let's just kind of work our way around the board here. So here we've got our terminal block where we put our solar plus and minus, and then we put our battery plus and minus. And if you're going to be using this for a load controller, you would put your load here. Now, the load control gives you a lot of different capabilities. The thing to keep in mind though is the charge controller itself, it's a PWM charge controller. So that means you have to match the nominal voltage of the battery bank to the nominal voltage of the solar array. So if you're using a 12 volt battery bank, you've got to do a 12 volt solar panel. If you're going to be doing a 24 volt battery bank, you can do either two 12 volt panels in series to get 24 volts, or you could do 24 volt solar panels. So you need to make sure this is PWM, which is new for MidNite. So PWM, you have to match the voltage of the panel to the battery. So what this is saying is with this load control is if you have, say you're doing a 12 volt system and you've got a 12 volt load like a light that you want to control with the charge controller, you now can use it so that you've got 10 amps are available for the load and 20 amps will be available for the solar. So it's a 30 amp charge controller, but if you're using loads, it turns into a 20 amps for charging, 10 amps for loads. Keep that in mind. So let's say we're going to be putting a load on here, a light, and we want to have it turn on automatically from dusk to dawn. No problem. What we would just do is set this as having load control, having it set to be timed, and then this knob right here gives us the ability to set different configurations. So we've got a whole list, nice little cheat sheet right here of different options where you can have it on for 3 hours after dusk, on for 6 hours after dusk, on for 3 hours after dusk and 2 hours before dawn. So you've got a lot of configurability right here. You can also have it set so that it stays on until the battery gets too low. And if the battery is low, it will automatically turn off. Now, if we take a look at the switches here, I have to get my glasses for this one. Aha! So our first setting here is, as I said, for the solar clock, so that it will automatically figure out based on when the sun comes up and sun goes down. And it's going to figure that out because you've got a great big sun sensor right there, your solar panel. So it can figure out if the sun is up or if the sun is down. So it'll take a week's worth of data and figure out from then what time of day it is, and we'll turn things on and off based on that. And because, as you know, the time changes throughout the year, it's going to keep track of that, and it will truly be turning things on based on the real dusk and dawn. So our second switch is parallel. So what that is if you're going to be using it just for a solar charge controller, not doing any load control, you're going to be wiring both the load plus and the Solar Plus together in parallel, and you're going to switch this and show that, yes, I'm using this in parallel, which means I'm using all 30 amps for solar charging. And then your next is whether it's going to be a 12 or a 24 volt battery bank. And then you've got two settings for what type of battery, if it's sealed, if it's flooded, if it's all different types. It supports lots of different types, including other. So it gives you some flexibility as to what voltage it will charge to. And then the next one is actually deep versus light. Now what that is that's deep discharge versus light discharge. So if you're doing a low voltage disconnect and you have a really critical load and you are willing to sacrifice the health of your battery to let that load run as long as possible, you can set it for a deep discharge. So instead of turning off at, say, 11.7 volts for a low battery, it will go all the way down to 11 volts. So it'll give you just a little bit more time with that load. And regardless of if you have it set at 11.7 or at 11 volts, it'll still turn back on once the battery comes back up to 12.6 volts. So then the last one is auto equalize. Now, if you've got flooded batteries, you're going to want to be equalizing that, which means sending a really high voltage to the battery bank just to kind of shake things up a little bit. So if you've got it set on auto equalize, when the charge controller has got a high enough voltage coming from the batteries, coming from the solar panels, it will actually send that power to the batteries for 2 hours to give it a real good equalization. And then if you have it set for auto, it's going to do that again in 30 days. So every 30 days, it will send us a nice, good, heavy charging. So it will not do that for sealed. Remember, you only want to do that for flooded. So that is all of those. And then we go down to this button. This button has different uses based on where you are in the system. You can use it to test your loads. You can use it to reset any fault conditions. Or if you don't have auto equalize on and you want to manually equalize your flooded batteries, you press that and hold it, and that will trigger it to send the high voltage for the 2 hours. Then we talked about the strain reliefs already. And then we've actually got a little temperature sensor. So it does do temperature compensation. So it's going to make sure that if you've got a colder or hotter temperature, it's going to change the rate that it charges based on the temperature. So that is really good for the health of your batteries. So that is it in a nutshell, the MidNite BRAT.